I'm ready. Oh God, there it is. Okay, you
this
can
is 223.
222.
222 was
Those
last weekend.
deuces. Oh, you marked the Minnesota's
I did.
222. You gotta tell
Yeah.
me these things, Sonny. You marked the
It
Minnesota's
shows up
222.
on the feed. Are we live? Is that why you're talking like that?
Yes, I am.
Okay.
Yes.
Hey, greetings. I'd like to say hello and welcome to the Games Only podcast. We thought it was episode 222, but it's actually 223. If you're only watching in video mode, you missed last week's show. We'll see what we can do to get
We'll
that up
try
to
and get you
speed.
something of sunflower talking to like a blue ice cream cone or something like that.
Yeah, we'll figure out a picture, but regardless, welcome. My name is Sunflower, and I'm here with Doc from the great Central Park in the sky.
The
So
greatest of
we're here
all
to talk.
Central Parks.
Yeah, the it's what one would call a central. We are missing HP and blue tonight. However, we will soldier on because that's what we do. So speaking of soldiers, Doc, you said you played a bunch of Street Fighter V, and you soldiered on to the bronze tier of fighter.
Super bronze,
So
man.
that's better than
I'm
bronze.
past that bronze. I'm in that super bronze, right?
Okay. How long did that take you?
It ebbs and flows. In terms of the number of fights it took me, maybe about 50 in terms of win some, lose some. But the system's set up where you win about 60 points every single. You get about 60 points every single time you win, and then you only lose about 20 to 30 points every single time you lose, depending on how good of a person you're playing.
Right.
So it's not like it's I had to win a big streak and have a plus average or anything like that. I could be batting 500 right now and everything would be okay.
Sure.
Yeah.
So it didn't take you that long.
No, not that long. And
That's
it's mentioned before, it's not a frustrating game, which is really nice. It's if I lose, I know I lost on purpose. Even if this Ken player was being dumb and just doing uppercuts all over the place, it's like, well, I was the dumbass that decided not to block it. There's no like stupid shenanigan setups or anything like that, that it's like, well, I couldn't get out of that unblockable mix-up or anything like that. I couldn't do anything with like that. So
certainly.
it's like, okay, it was my fault, or alternatively, that person was better than me. So those are my generally two options.
Now, Capcom revealed their patch notes for an upcoming patch in March. They did not give a specific date. We've got a lot of March left, but it includes a new character. But another thing they have that I thought was pretty interesting is that they have a rematch button for ranked play. So if you feel somebody got away with something and you would like to try fighting them again,
Yeah.
if they agree also, you get the rematch. That's
Nice.
kind of cool.
That is pretty cool.
It's very simple, and I'm surprised nobody had thought of it before. Because yeah, sometimes you get people are angry, like, man, that's bullshit, and then they're gone. So instead of having to drag it over to a private match and do it again for
Yeah,
nothing,
invite
just
them, hope they come in just for brownie points, right?
yeah. So
They
that's
also are starting to enforce some I think you call them cheaters, people that are just
rage quitters.
backing out of games before the points start to calculate, right?
Yeah, they're doing that by hand, which is terrible.
Currently they're doing it by hand, and then they're trying to implement a system because they had to get data first to be able to figure out who the actual offenders were and then how they can actually enforce that type of thing. So
That really blows my mind.
I think in the March patch, yeah, that they didn't think about it, I agree. But I think in like the
It's not like this
March.
is new to them. Like even so far back as Tatsunoko versus Capcom, which was on the Wii, they were the ones who introduced the hey, if you quit a bunch of games, you'll only be matched with people that quit a bunch of games again.
Yeah, you're
That's
going into rage
great.
quit hell for the most part, right?
Yeah. So
I think it's because they're trying to streamline their system where everybody should be playing rank. There's no reason why you should play anything other than rank, so they want everybody in there. For points and things like that. That's their main focus is fight money and league points. But yeah, currently they're doing it by hand. And the number one player, there's two players that actually got up to 10,000 league points this past week. One's an actual professional player, and the other one was some unknown guy from Japan. And the second they started checking things by hand, that guy lost 9,000 points in one day. Just put him right back down to like 800 points or so. So
yeah.
yeah.
It's kind of curious how Street Fighter V has been doing because on PSN for the digital downloads, it ranked number 5 for the month, which is surprisingly low. I expect it to do a lot better, but then you say, well, that's split with physical. But it like lost out to games like
No,
Firewatch.
it's a niche game. I mean, it absolutely is a niche game. You're not expecting it to sell as high as anything else. Same thing with Mortal Kombat. It's a niche game.
Yeah, well,
Might have name recognition, but it's still very limited in scope in the types of people who actually play it.
So it didn't do too well digitally, at least compared to Street Fighter 4, I would imagine. The physical copies actually came out today. They did not have the actual sales numbers, but Street Fighter 5 placed in physical sales, ranked number 7 behind. You ready for this?
Oh, I'm ready.
And this was also the case in digital as well. It was ranked behind Naruto Shippuden Ultimate Ninja Storm. So a little anime fighting game
Yeah.
outsold Street Fighter 5. That's kind of hard to
Remember, anime
stomach.
fighting game with a story mode, though.
Yeah, that's
Yeah.
true. But how much of that, I mean, like, how informed are consumers really that they would stop and be like, oh, no, I know about this. I don't think they're that
No, I
informed.
mean, I don't believe they ever have really good sales numbers for these fighting games. I mean, to be ranked behind Naruto is, it's something. But is that Naruto across all three platforms, right? Because remember, Street Fighter V is console exclusive and on PC, right? So,
Right. This is not including PC sales, period.
okay, so that's just console sales.
That
So,
is
I
correct.
mean, they have two consoles going for Naruto, and it's one of those things where companies really need to think about being exclusive for
Well,
consoles
here's
for those
another
types of sales, right?
a little note to this is that the PS4 version of Naruto alone outsold
Alone.
Street Fighter V.
Okay, so that's even better.
So it's not necessarily that it was available on two, because on
Yeah.
one it took care of it, but man, that's honestly really surprising because it's not like Naruto's at the height of its popularity right now. It's starting to wane a bit. It's been around. But then again, you could say the same about Street Fighter, but I'm really surprised that it performed
I'm
that
not, because
poorly.
even when you're like, oh, Street Fighter 4, I don't think Street Fighter 4 was all that popular when it was released as well, even at any of the iterations.
Well, Street Fighter 4 opened up to 850,000 sales physically across all the platforms.
Yeah.
This one has done under 200,000.
Oh,
That's
wow.
a pretty big drop off.
That's pretty low, right? And
And part of that is because it's only on one platform, but even then.
they released in the same window too, wasn't it? This February,
Yeah,
March type
it
of
was early in the
window,
year, I
right?
believe.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I mean, I don't know. I guess even though it seems like it's more visible than ever,
I mean
I think people
that it released in what, 2009, so people had their next gen consoles for about 3 4 years, and it's
couple
a
years, a few years.
yeah, so it's pretty similar in terms of the actual market.
Yeah,
Yeah.
it's just, man, I don't know if the competitive scene has kind of turned off casual people from jumping in. I mean, we always hear about new people. Oh, I knew they got into this Street Fighter and then they got really good. But
I
I
mean,
think it might be pushing people back a little.
it's hard for new people to get into these games, unless you are determined for the most part. And as you mentioned, there's no real good tutorial mode or anything like that. So unless you are,
Not yet.
unless you're willing to go through videos and tutorials outside of the actual system itself,
Yeah.
it's not the the
A
hallmark of the
real
actual
high barrier of
series.
entry if you want to have fun.
Yeah.
Apparently, Far Cry Primal, though, doing wonderful and has beaten Far Cry 4 on launch. I didn't expect it to get even bigger,
That
but I guess
dinosaur
not with
game?
Primal.
That their
Yeah, that
dinosaur
dinosaur
game? How much is Far Cry Primal?
$60,
Oh,
just like
it's a
everything
full
else.
release? I was hoping it was gonna be like Blood Dragon, right?
That's a negative.
Yeah.
Primal is a full game, even though they use the same map as Far Cry 4. It's just completely repurposed, which I
Well,
actually kind of like
it's
that.
okay to use the same map because it's thousands of
It's the
years in the
same
past,
world.
right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I really like that, even though it was probably just because, oh, we can save some money, so let's do
Of
this.
course.
I still like the fact that you're in the same
Well,
place.
you like that nostalgia factor. As you're walking around, you can actually look and feel and say, oh, I remember this point. It was completely different when I played it earlier, but
Reminds
I
me of the
remember
good
this area.
old days of 2015 when I was
Yeah.
playing Far Cry
Well,
4.
not like
Not
nostalgia
that
as in
much
like the good
nostalgia.
old days, but it's like I remember this area here. There was a fort over here. I used an elephant to bash through, and now it's a nice forest because it's
Yeah.
before that time, right?
Lots of forest, lots of vegetation, fruits, trees. That brings us to Stardew
Well,
Valley.
have you been playing any more Street Fighter 4 by any chance? Or Street Fighter 5? 4, sorry.
No,
No?
I don't feel like it.
Yeah.
Times actually atrocious, but the method of getting out of a game and getting into a new one just takes too long that I don't pick it up casually. It sucks. I wish I could. It's one of those games where honestly, after you're done fighting, instead of going to another mode, you're better off just sitting at the main menu for a few minutes waiting for a fight.
That's what I do. I just have something
I
else
don't want that.
happening on the screen and on the other screen, and I just leave the search queue up.
Yeah,
I
and I don't
mean,
have a good way for
it
that.
is nice that you can turn on fight request and you can do it from any menu you actually want.
Oh,
So you can always go to training mode and practice there and then get called into a fight if necessary. So
yeah.
there's those options, but it's still waiting because you're waiting to get into the training mode now while you're waiting for the game, and it's still waiting for the most part.
Yeah. Street Fighter 4 seems much snappier than it Street Fighter 5 does with that respect, or in that respect, rather. But anyway, so yeah, Street Fighter, we get Alex this month, so that'll be fun if we play as him. I am a season pass owner like an idiot.
See, I don't. Do you know how much fight money they're charging for characters?
I heard something like 100,000,
Oh,
maybe. It
woo.
might even be 1 million. I'm not sure. I can't remember what your normal amount
I mean,
is.
it's not surprising. You have to beat like hard survival mode, all like 50 fights to be able to get colors for your characters, so.
Yeah, and I did a little bit of research into how the microtransactions work, like from the publisher's perspective, or the developers in this case. And the reason that they have you able to buy everything with fight money is so that you squander it on colors and outfits and not actually use it on characters. So they price those guys out of there
At like seemingly out
much
of
more
reach.
quickly.
Yeah.
Yeah, even though they're not, but people will end up biting on the costumes and biting on the colors instead of the
And
characters.
thus
So.
then thus can't save up for the characters and buy more costumes and colors, right?
Right, because the season pass is for the characters, not for a bunch of costumes.
Oh, the costumes are pretty dope though. I mean,
Oh yeah.
a lot of the alternative costumes they have, it's
It's free money,
their
almost.
the alternative costumes are better than the original costumes. Like Cammy actually has something that's covering up her lower regions in an alternative costume. It's like, oh, that's actually nice. I might play as Cammy. That way I don't have to stare at this thing anymore.
Well, that was Street Fighter. Stardew Valley,
Yeah.
we're harvesting, we're cutting things. There's a Harvest Moon competitor out there done by some white dude in America. And you know what? It's just as good as our old Harvest Moon games. Have you played a Harvest Moon game before, Doc?
Way, 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 way back. So,
PS1 and 64?
Super Nintendo? Was there one for Super
Oh, wow.
Nintendo?
Yeah, that
Yeah.
must have been. If there was, it was one of the first.
Yeah, it might have been a Japanese game that I emulated, so it's
Oh,
it, but
wow.
it was a while ago.
So, this is Stardew Valley, a Harvest Moon inspired game that is basically Harvest Moon, like straight up. You have your own farm that you inherit, and you plant things, and you talk to villagers, and you get in little relationships with them, and you do stuff, and you explore, and you mine, and you plant, and you sell, and you plant. How do you like it? Do you like this?
Well, it's plotting, right? That's how the game typically is. It's just
Especially at the beginning.
yeah, especially at the beginning. And I'm not too far into it. I did get some parsnips. I did finally manage to grow all the parsnips,
It is very
and
good.
it's designed in a way where I was like, okay, my mission is plant these parsnips, water them all day, all every day for 4 days, and then harvest them, right? And they're not really giving me much of anything else besides that. Not a lot of other cues besides go talk to some of the townspeople, talk to the fishermen, got a fishing pole. But then the second you harvest the parsnips, they're like, all of a sudden it's like, oh, now here's some more tutorials for you to do. So it seemingly felt like they're just like, you're out in the wilderness, you're out in the world, have fun, kid. And then the second I did that, I'm like, oh, they are giving me more direction. They're giving me more tutorial. So I'm happy about that.
Yes.
But man, the fishing's fun. Fishing minigame is fun. Did you
Fishing is
do you
fun.
like the fishing?
I do.
I thought it was very novel how they did it and actually difficult. Because you have to click your mouse to put a bar up that matches up where the fish is swimming, and it goes up and
Yeah.
down and the clicks. It's
Takes real
really
effort.
quite good. It's not just one of those go in blind mini games. So it's interesting. Tired
One thing
myself
I've
out a couple games really
Oh, yeah.
quickly though. Oh man, that
Tired myself
stamina.
out the first morning.
Yeah, that stamina is real. Because I'm gonna clear all this shit. I got my scythe, and then it's like, okay, you're tired. I'm like, okay, so I'm not gonna do anything. I'm gonna be overtired soon. And then because every the all your items are mapped to your click, and you want to click on things, and you still have your axe out, you just swing your axe, and all of a sudden it's like, oh, now you're tired. I'm like, oh fuck. And then when you rest, you only get half your stamina back as opposed to all your stamina. So.
I went to bed at a nice little 11:30 in the morning on my first day, and it's pretty
And
sad.
that's how they save the game too. You have to actually rest to save the game. So it feels a little bit weird because you're like, well, if I actually have to go and save the game, there goes the day. But them's are the breaks, I suppose.
But Steam Workshop support is coming. Can't wait. That should be ridiculous, the kind of things that you can do with
Oh,
that game.
yeah.
Should be pretty great. $50. I'm having a heck of a lot of fun, and I much prefer this to where Harvest Moon ended up going.
So I mean, Blue talks about it. What to, in your point of view, where's Harvest Moon like currently? Do you have a feel for it?
I haven't been keeping up to for the most current versions of it, but I remember that there were, and I'm starting to look this up. Of course, I look up the real Harvest Moon, what an actual Harvest Moon is instead of the game.
Oh,
So, and
yes.
thanks, Neil Young is all up in here as well. That doesn't help either. But they've moved on to mostly handheld games,
Yeah, but
Story of Seasons,
social
stuff like that.
stimu so social simulators as opposed to farming simulators mostly, right? You still do a little farming, but it's mostly about the social interactions.
Normally, yeah.
Yeah.
It started getting a little weird when they started making you like a shopkeeper
Oh.
and all sorts of really other strange things they've been doing. The farm story, the land of beginning, and things like that, where you're like making weapons and building things like that. It's been really strange where it's been headed because it's been getting further and further away from the core, which was, oh, over the course of, a decade or two, build relationships with people and farm. And that sounds real simple, but it's been getting very strange. So I don't know, it's unusual, and there's apparently some issues with the Harvest Moon name.
Yeah, I think
No
the
one is
last
calling
game Blue played, it was made by the Harvest Moon people, but it wasn't called Harvest Moon, right?
right, which would be called Story of
Story
Seasons.
of Seasons, yes.
Although the people who originally owned Harvest Moon, they're making their own Harvest Moon games also, which is really confusing. It
Yeah.
sounds like I don't even
But
know.
we can confirm that Stardew Valley is its own thing.
It is its own
Yeah.
thing, even though it apes a lot of parts of Harvest Moon. It is its own game and doesn't look like it's in any danger of being shut down at this point, especially. And it's being made by one dude.
Oh
Just
man, I think they
one
sold like
dude.
450,000 copies already.
That is
Like
crazy.
seriously, where did I see that? I think I saw it on Steam. Let me see if I can't pull that up somewhere.
It's been selling quite a bit, though, like no doubt. So that's really cool that, like, with word of mouth and a little, I mean, this has RPG Maker kind of all over it. I don't know. You've played a lot more RPG Maker games than I have. Do
I mean,
you think it is?
it has the graphical style, but I guarantee it was not made in RPG Maker engine. Right, I
Okay.
guarantee it wasn't made in the RPG Maker engine. It has that graphical feel to it, but in RPG Maker, you really can't do all too much on the world map with a lot of actual actions.
Right.
I mean, you still can get that in there, but I mean, not to this style, not to this type of class and as much nuanced as it is with the scythe. If scythe feels different than the axe, which feels different than the hoe and all that different type of stuff.
Apparently, there's a ton of secrets in this game, too.
Yeah.
Surprise. But
Well,
yeah,
there's a little cave next to the house where you start, and there's nothing in there. So I'm like, oh, what's going down in this cave? I don't know, maybe later.
4 hours ago, this story hit the internet. Stardew Valley mod fills the game with Pokemon. Last thing we need is
Yeah.
Pokemon in here. Like, that sounds like a big amount of trouble. So, I don't know. I like it though. It's good.
Yeah, Stardew Valley has sold 425,000 copies.
That's pretty impressive for a game that doesn't have any marketing whatsoever.
Well, I mean, I think it was I think it was Kickstarted or something of the like first. So that gets you some copies. But yeah, I mean, it's I guess people have been itching for one of these Harvest Moon games. They haven't been itching for another Street Fighter, but they've been itching for the more Harvest Moon games, so
Hey, go figure. But there's, a certain kind of enjoyment out of the mundane when it comes to a game. It gets you in a zone, so people say. So we'll see. Anyway, I really like it for 15 bucks if you're the type of person who the idea of building your own farm with what you want in there and livestock, things like that. If that appeals to you, it sounds perfect. It sounds perfect for you. And I've got a friend who has, apparently, I would like to think she has it on early access, but she's got over 270 hours in that game already, so it won't get old.
well, it's been out for like 12 days, so unless she was on it the entire time, she had to have early
She must have
access
been a backer,
somehow.
yeah.
Yeah, she had early access
Backer.
somehow.
Even then, 270 hours is nothing to sneeze at. That's
No,
damn.
not at all. That's almost encroaching Marvel Puzzle Quest time.
Yeah. So, starting to dig it a lot, and I think I probably like it the least out of everybody who's on the Games Only podcast. Like, I will like it the least. I don't think Blue has had the chance to play it yet, or HP. And I've always had a hard time clicking with Harvest Moon games, but man,
I mean,
a lot of other people are going to like this a lot more than I do.
I've been looking for a good just do other stuff and then play a game while the other stuff is happening type of game. So this fits that niche. So like Marvel Puzzle Quest, where something else is happening, I listen to a podcast, watching a video, something like that, and I can still play that.
Right.
So this fits that niche for me. So I think I should play it. Which means I should buy it because I'm just family sharing it from you currently.
Oh, I thought you bought it. Well, $15,
No,
very
that's a very good price.
It is. It absolutely is. Even though the visuals look quite dated, and it's pretty weird to play it with a mouse and keyboard when I'm so used to console controls
Yeah,
or
I
hand.
agree. Like I said, I think the weirdest part is the fact that I want to click on things to interact, and to interact with objects it's right click. So usually it's like an axe comes down. It doesn't hurt the person when an axe comes down.
Thank God.
But it's just like, oh, there goes more stamina that I wish I had. So,
Yeah. Got to be careful with that. But I look forward to putting more time into it. And I believe you do as well. And hopefully we can hear from our other two co-hosts also. This game also seems like it'd be perfect for a phone and tablet. Because, Jesus, touch controls, that'd be just fine with me.
Well, I mean, it was the one developer, and now that he's sold 420,000
Probably
copies,
hires.
I'm sure he can port it out to other things. He has time to port it out.
Yeah, that's true. So that is Stardew Valley. Highly recommended so far. It's only going to get crazier as time goes on, and when Steam Workshop support comes in, I bet you'll be able to brush your cows and chickens until they start shining and making quivering eyes at you, like one of those Harvest Moon games did. But eventually, you leave the farm. And when you leave the farm, where do you end up? In the Octagon. I played UFC 2. That EA Access coming through
Oh,
with
is that what they're doing? They had UFC for this new generation. Now it's UFC 2. They're not tagging a year on the end of that.
it's UFC because they had UFC Undisputed series last
Okay.
generation of games, and that was not made by EA. That was made by somebody else. I can't remember who. And those were good games. And then there was EA MMA.
Yes, the
And I think they made an EA MMA 2, and then there was some weird half affliction game or something that was called punished or beaten or something
With what
weird
one of
like that.
the other
Supremacy, MMA
groups.
Supremacy, that one. And things got a little weird, and when the new consoles came out, they came out with EA UFC, which was okay. And then they did EA UFC 2, which has actually got the UFC license for sure. Like, it had it before with EA UFC,
Yeah,
but
of course.
this one, they're kind of dealing with a boom period in UFC right now, where a lot of people are paying attention, which is really nice because they've got a lot of stars that are actually doing a lot of talking and getting a lot of people's attention, as opposed to in the
Cut
past.
those promos.
Yeah, there was always kind of the disconnect. Like, people would compare it to wrestling, and they'd say, well, UFC's more exciting to watch, but the characters Who cares? They're just people, and they don't have any motivations beyond wanting to win the fight. And that kind of gave rise to people that could pull in a whole bunch of money by talking shit, because no one was talking shit. So when
I think Chuck Liddell was in Tino Ortiz, I think, were the only ones that were actually talking shit back in the 90s.
Yeah.
So,
yeah, there wasn't
early aughts. That was it. Out of all
a lot of it was very respectful because, you know, anyone who's trained in any sort of discipline respects
any type of martial arts whatsoever.
Yeah. And even sports, like, you're supposed to respect the other people. So people start talking crap. And that's been getting a lot of people into watching more UFC because they want to see the guy who's an asshole get beat, or they really love the guy who's acting like a prick and they want to see him whip somebody's ass. And that's the key to money. Between that and Ronda Rousey being there up until her first loss, they definitely headed on a boom period. What's funny is that the two cover athletes of UFC 2, Ronda Rousey and Conor McGregor, both have lost recently. Last fight they lost, so the Madden
transferred. Even though Ronda Rousey lost, the person who beat her just lost this past week, she right?
did. Holly Holm was submitted in the last final round.
And so it's one of those things where it's like, oh, well, now she's the best. And all of a sudden it's like, no, now it's this. And you get that kind of that upper echelon now. So it plays quite nicely as opposed to one person just always
dominating. Well, and here's the thing. Miesha Tate was the one who beat Holly Holm, which was who beat Ronda Rousey. Ronda Rousey has beaten Miesha Tate twice before.
Yeah.
So what's next? We'll see how that all plays out. I'm sure Ronda's next for Tate.
She might not even fight again. She doesn't have to.
No, she's made her money. Yeah. She's a star, like legitimate, but I think she'll probably be back. Anywho, so the game looks really good, has a few little technical hiccups. On loading screens, the music, because it plays licensed music during loading screens and during regular screens as well, kind of slows down like an old tape player because it's pulling too much data from the hard drive.
You mean like the song actually slows down? Like it plays at a slower rate?
It doesn't stutter. You don't get like little gaps or anything like that. It doesn't freeze. It slows down. It feels like it's trying to get up a hill.
Like if you're playing your 45 on the 33 setting, right? Just slows it on down.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's really funny to hear because really I'm like, this sounds like it's starting to run out of juice, and then you're like, oh no,
that and then it just starts to speed up all of a sudden, get back on track.
Yeah, and then it's back to where it needs to be. So that's something.
Yet again, you got to worry about those games with licensed music for streaming, recording, anything like that.
That is also true.
Which I know you had a problem with the WWE with that, right?
I did. It was really foolish of them to block audio from entrances because that is a huge part of making your own stupid little creations is coming out to your music. That's such a big deal.
That cold necklace track.
If you've ever listened to Cold Necklace, you know what I'm talking about. If not, soundcloud.com/coldnecklace. Check it out. You'll really like it. So I've been playing some UFC 2, a couple hours of it. There are three different modes of gameplay in it, so to speak. There is the both fighters standing up in striking distance, so it's a striking game there. You can try to shoot for a takedown where it turns into the grappling game on the ground, which is very different. Or you can get into a clinch, which is kind of similar to the ground game as well.
Just standing up,
From either one of those last two, you can do a submission if your fighter knows a submission move. And my God, is it hard to wrap my head around doing it. It's just not fun to do. Like, you have to like hold the left trigger and hold the right stick in a certain direction to try to shoot in for a takedown. Okay, that's fine. You realize that you don't just flick it like you used to in other games. You know, those old Fight Night games where you would just flick the right stick and you'd perform. Hey, that was cool. I like that. Quarter circles and stuff like that to do a different uppercut, things like that. It felt natural. This one, you're doing a lot of holding and it feels weird to hold for 2-3 seconds while they get into that and can be countered. I have a real hard time countering others. I still don't fully understand that. I spent some time in training mode trying to learn that because I knew that I would spend a lot of time on the ground or in the clinch. But man, so I'll just tell you.
Is it less like quick time mini games and more like.
Yeah, it's not at all.
It's just counter and reaction and knowing what move to counter with. And
if I'm saying to myself, okay, I'm not going to shoot in for the takedown, but they're going to. I need to know which direction they're moving, hold a different trigger, and move towards that with mine, hopefully quicker than theirs. It's really uneven feeling, and I'm not liking the game when I'm in any hold. So that doesn't appeal to me. The striking feels like lots of fun. It's all physics-based, which is also really cool. So if somebody is moving towards where you're punching, like say they made the wrong move and they're trying to duck when you're doing an uppercut, based on the speed that you're hitting them, you could knock them out. That's really cool. I like it that it's physics-based in that respect. So all the punches that actually knock somebody out look like they make sense, like there's a good reason for them to go down like that. So that's really cool. But here's the other thing about this game. Like, striking's lots of fun, so I just made a dude who excels at striking.
Do not put me on the ground, because I don't know anything.
God knows there's been plenty of other fighters like that too. Like, that's just...
I am the Butterbeam of MMA.
Pretty much. So they've got... Ultimate Team in UFC now, which is that card game that has been attached to every EA Sports franchise for quite some time.
That's HP talked about with Madden.
Yeah, a lot more manageable here, because instead of a roster of hundreds and thousands like you would get with NFL or any other, like NHL, sports, I don't know how many cards. You have five characters that you make. You've got your own fight camp of your own dudes. You got five dudes or women that you can make, and every pack that you open has moves in it or buffs for your character. Like, you did leg training, so your legs are stronger, and you apply them to your fighters, and their overall rating will go up based on what you're giving them. And sometimes you can unlock special moves in there too, not like a fireball, but, you know, kind of a signature move that is probably really
Superman punch or something like that.
And you basically apply it to their moveset, which is actually really cool, and I'm really digging that a lot. And what you do is, so I made myself Sunny Flores, because they didn't have Flowers in this one as a last name, so I had to be Sunny Flores.
Hey, that works, though.
It does.
That's scooting around a different culture to get the same means. It's fine.
Yep, and because I was using that last name, I went with the nickname El Presidente. Sure, let's do that. So you can play live online with other people to earn more money if you want, or you can play their offline championship where they go online, download somebody else's created character, and you fight them with the AI.
Okay.
So that's cool, because you're seeing custom dudes, and you're fighting them without actually having to fight somebody who knows how the game works a hell of a lot better than you do. So
they got to put that in a wrestling game. Like, you start a Royal Rumble, and you don't know who's coming down that ramp whatsoever, but you're playing AI, right?
Yeah, what was neat is that in one of the 2K games last, I think it was 2K15, not 16, they had kind of a career mode where you started at the bottom, and all the other little scrubs around you were your friends' dudes if they made them.
Okay.
That's really cool. The only problem is I didn't have any friends that would play.
But wouldn't that be awesome if it was Royal Rumble, you just pull 30 yourself, and then 29 random dudes offline, and you have no idea who's coming down there?
Yeah, like every person who
would be in the outfit coming out in
camouflage shorts and like combat boots and a black shirt. You're like, oh yeah, another one of these guys.
But then you get like the one gem who it's like, it's the mosquito, and he's got like the full nylon suit on jumping around. Right?
And what would be great is if you could track their progress, and like, he showed up in four Royal Rumbles and won two of them.
Oh yeah,
and you get benefits. Kind of like a bot.
Yeah.
In some way. Some respect. So that would be really cool.
We got to call. Who's got that? Activision? Who's got that license?
2K? 2K.
So is that 2K Activision?
No, I don't believe it is.
I'll look it up. You keep talking about the UFC. You keep talking about UFC.
Well, and that's kind of the end of it, is that since I made a striker, I'm having fun with their Ultimate Fighter mode. They've got a really, really big roster. Like, that's totally cool that they've got it. All the different weight classes, things like that. And lots of female fighters, which is also very cool to see represented in a game, especially considering UFC has been... They found out that women fighters are a big draw, big money draw. Like, people want to see it, too. There's personalities. It's the same as anything else would be. So, I'm enjoying the game, but I'm not loving it. Like, I get the feeling if I ever get forced to have to do a lot of that grappling, I'm just going to put it up.
Yeah.
I'm just going to be done with it. So,
It is that's 2K is the publisher, by the way.
Ah,
Take-Two is the distributor. So
okay, yeah. And who developed it was Yuke's.
Yuke's
totally sucks. Like, they're garbage. They're just garbage. Oh, they're terrible.
Never heard of them. That's because I don't buy the rest.
They have been making WWE games for a long time, and everyone was pretty psyched. They were like, "Oh, WWE, the license has been lost by EA or whoever had it before, so maybe we'll actually get it." It wasn't EA, but
Activision then, yeah.
Actually, I think it might have been. Yeah. Everyone was really psyched. They're like, "Oh, new developers, new WWE game. This is going to be great." And then 2K was just like, "And we're bringing back Yuke's."
People who were making it before.
Which is probably why they brought it back, because it's a lot cheaper to do it that way. Yeah. So,
anyway, is that the only game they make? I've never heard of Yuke's before in my life. Is that the only games they make?
They did a few fighting games previously.
Like what? Like Clay Fighter? Like, what do you mean by fighting games?
Well, they've been making WWE games.
Oh, God, they've been making games for 99. Years. Holy shit.
Yeah,
they could have made Clay Fighter for all I know. Oh my goodness!
They did make the Berserk Millennium Falcon game for the PS2. That was
okay.
That I really loved.
Okay,
really loved that game. But they make a lot of garbage. Dog Island, which is probably a great game. They made UFC 2009 Undisputed, which I did enjoy that game too.
Finding Nemo.
But yeah, they are almost
Rumble Roses. They made Rumble Roses.
Okay. Almost exclusively WWE games. Yeah, that's pretty rare.
Looks like in the 2000s, wrestling and racing games is pretty much what
they did. Yeah.
WWE, so. Wrestle Kingdom, Rumble Roses. Oh my goodness, they have every wrestle game. UFC Undisputed.
Yeah.
Okay.
Very good. But has that Yuke's jank? It's a little different than UFC because they don't have to. Whatever.
Yeah.
But. Yeah, so that's UFC 2. I like the striking, and I like the way it looks. I would call myself probably an intermediate-level fighting fan, as far as MMA goes. Mm. I'm not as hardcore as the people that are watching these amazing Russian live streams where people are literally making entrances off of a cargo boat, which is so awesome.
That's pretty good, man. That's pretty good.
Yeah.
Is that you like one of the Emelianko's? They get the cargo boat, right? Yeah.
It's like done in a cloudy afternoon somewhere in Russia outdoors. It's just like,
you can tell. You can tell it's frozen, but there's a moat around the ring that's all misty and whatnot, right?
Yeah, it's got that kind of stank coming off the ground.
All I'm happy is that fucking 5-on-5 combat league never took off, man. That is some crazy shit.
That's a pretty amazing thing, though.
That's, in a way. It's so wrong, though. It is so wrong.
Very terrible. Yeah. But anyway, EA Access, if you've got an Xbox One, throw down $5, try it for 10 hours. That's really a good rental when you think about it. Plus, you get all access to the EA Vault anyhow. Lots of games there. So.
And according to you, you might get tired with the grappling that after 10 hours, you had enough.
Certainly. Absolutely. And, so far it doesn't seem to be pushing me towards having to do that. I mean, unless I want to play Certain fighters, so that's great, but it's gonna get really lame when I have 5 people on my ultimate team and they're all strikers like that. Like, these guys all like to stand up and punch. I'm like, oh, wow. But yeah, I mean, I don't know, it's cool, it looks good, it looks like it's an improvement, but I don't like the idea of holding directions down to grapple. Like, there's got to be a better way. Damn it, there has to be a better
way. I mean, it's quick time events and mini games previously, so they're trying to go in some direction. What happened? I mean, it's a shame that boxing isn't big, because those fight nights were good. Those were good games. The twin stick fighting, that was some good.
I enjoyed
game.
Them. Yeah. I enjoyed them a lot. And I kind of get that from the stand-up punching and kicking in this game.
I enjoy pretty much any sports game that's a twin stick type of thing. Like Gran Turismo at some point allowed you to do twin stick controls. Gas and brake on the right
accelerate.
Gas and brake on the right analog stick. Like, I didn't really want to learn that at first, but once I learned how to play like that, it was really good. It was really good. But then they made triggers, and it's like, well, why would you use anything else? You now have triggers. So,
yeah. Very true. So, that's UFC 2. Like I said, try it. EA Access is totally worth it. If you're on PS4, try renting it. You got to make sure that you enjoy the actual gameplay. The Ultimate Team is probably the most accessible it's ever been, but I'm not going to spend real money on it, so help me God. I better not spend real money on it.
So also on EA Access, you've been playing more Plants vs. Zombies 2?
I have, except I actually bought the game.
Oh, look at you.
Because I like it so much, I bought it.
Yeah, why not? Right?
I mean, I
Like I said,
played eight, some like 8 of my 10 hours of trial time.
I should buy the game because what I enjoyed the original, and also when the nieces or nephews are over for holidays,
Oh,
that's a good game for them to play. It's a really good game
yeah.
for them to play.
And EA Access, Plants vs. Zombies Modern Garden Warfare 1 is in the vault as well, so you can just play that for
Well,
free.
I already own it, so
Hey, perfect. Well, you know, since you own it, you get lots of unlockables in Plants vs. Zombies 2 as well. They
Okay.
check your PvZ 1 rank and any
Rank?
unlock.
They have ranks in that?
Yeah, there are ranks. And they pull in your unlockable characters. They have all
Okay.
migrated, which
Yeah.
is cool. So if you've been unlocking dudes
Do
that you
I
like,
get to
you can get
keep
them.
the mustache for my cactus?
I believe you do, yes.
Nice, nice.
I didn't have too many unlockables, but I pulled over a few that I did have, which was nice, like a chomper, you know, those big Venus flytrap looking sort of guys that have teeth. He was basically a hot rod, so when he eats somebody, he gets a speed boost and can fly around. That's pretty cool.
Nice. That's cool.
Because every variation of these, because there's like 7 or 8 different, or 6 or 7 different characters you can play on each side, they've all got multiple variations, and each variation actually plays a little bit differently, which is great. So I've got 2 different scientists, zombie scientists. I've got the regular one who heals and he shoots a gun, and then I've got one that uses animals to fire. So up close, he's like firing off porcupine spurs and stuff like that, and he looks very different too. So you can actually find a variant of a character that you like that completely fits your style, which is great. But man, 8 hours of this game that I've been playing in the trial has not been enough, and I saw it for $40 on Amazon the other day as it was a deal, and I said, you
Oh,
know what?
yeah.
I think I'll keep playing this because I can hop in and make progress on stuff alone. That's fine. I can play it with my friends. That's also lots of fun. They've got anything in the game you can do solo. Even multiplayer matches, you can fill them with bots and get all the same things that you would get if you were playing against other people. It's not like it's, oh yeah, you can play against bots, but you don't get anything. It's not like that. It's exactly what you get elsewhere, which is great and so important to me, like very much so.
Yeah, making progress.
There's tons of secrets out there. I don't know. And I
Now
really like the games.
on your list of games, does this rank number one on games sold, or does this come out in March and that's your February, is
Oh,
that February list, right? Because this is multi-platform. This isn't an Xbox One exclusive like last time. This is multiple
didn't hit the
consoles.
top 10 in February at all.
Yeah, did it come out in February? Or did it come out in March? Was it last week? No, it was 2 weeks ago. It was 2 weeks ago. It was probably right at the end of February. Yeah.
Plants vs. Zombies 2 released on July 9th. That is because that's Plants vs. Zombies 2.
Yeah, not Garden
And not
Warfare 2.
Modern War or
Yeah.
Garden Warfare 2. Jesus, GW2, not
I
MW.
gotcha. Yeah, the last week of
February
February.
23rd.
Yeah.
Even then, I don't think that this is going to really light up the charts, but I think it'll solidly sell for some time.
Yeah.
So it'll be fine. So if you do grab Plants vs. Zombies 2, feel free to jump in my game. Doesn't matter what you've got Hub World.
I tried that with Street Fighter, and you just stayed in training mode the whole time.
Yeah, for some reason the Capcom ID is
You did get it on
weird.
Xbox One, right? Because that's yeah, because you have EA access, yeah. So Xbox One,
That's
yeah.
correct. Actually, what you probably should do is just get EA Access and an Xbox One.
Well, it's not going to be 10 hours for the whole time, and like I said, I like to have it for the holidays.
Well, sure,
Yeah.
but you know, you get a discount if you buy digitally
You
an
keep pushing
EA
that
game.
EA access on me. I mean, it's nice,
It's
but it's not, and
probably one of the best
I don't
values.
think I would take advantage of it as I should.
Maybe not, but I
Yeah.
mean, there's a lot of games in that vault, all the sports games, and which is really nice, to be quite honest. If I get a wild hair up my ass and I want to play some FIFA, I can do that.
Yeah. Just to hate soccer some more, right?
Oh, God. You know, best soccer game I ever played was FIFA 64. And 64 is great. I love that game. Go figure. But I don't know, man. EA Access has been great. It bums me out that Sony doesn't want it on their platform. That is a real bummer.
That's 'cause, well, when it
It'll
was
cheapen
first
PlayStation Plus.
when it was first offered, they were into the whole PlayStation TV, all the they bought Genkai, right? They're all about the streaming and making money off of their own streaming service, and
Yeah.
that shit isn't taking off anytime soon, so they might switch their mind at some point. Not like
Maybe.
EA's gonna care. Oh, you denied us earlier, we're not gonna let you do it. No, they're like, yeah, fuck, you can take it, right? So
Yeah, so that's interesting. I don't know, man. Apparently, Plants vs. Zombies 2 is ranked like 18. So I don't know what that means because we don't have actual numbers. Ooh, actually, Street Fighter V is under 210,000. So there you go. Anyway.
US, you, I know it's now it's not doing well in Japan because they're all about the arcade scene. They're like, we have to buy a console. What's going on here, right?
Yeah, this is US.
Yeah.
So, anywho, that's that. So, Plants vs. Zombies 2, I'm still just having a lot of fun with it. It's rare that a game just seems to do everything right, and they did.
Well, they
Like,
were able to put some more polish on it from the first one, right? First
yeah.
one, be able to
And
figure out what they
it's
did
not a
right.
serious multiplayer game. Like, you can take it seriously if you want, but balance isn't the most important thing to that game because you just kind of have fun, and no one's trying to destroy everything, and you can get away from them. So, I don't know.
It helps that's not a Twitch shooter either. It really helps in that aspect.
Yeah, a lot of support kind of
It's
characters too.
more a la Team Fortress 2, and that style plays well for more casual people, so.
Sure does. But I totally dig it. So besides that, like I've been playing Saints Row 4 again for like the third time. Man, Saints Row 4 is probably my favorite open world game, like GTA style, like for real. It consistently makes me laugh, even at, though I've seen the jokes before again and again and again. God, I can do some really stupid shit in that game. Did you play
I just can't get into those games. I really can't. I played a lot of three. I played a decent amount of three.
3 was very good.
Yeah.
4 is just bliss, man. It's just so good. Anyway, is there anything else that you spent any time with? Did you pick up the Division?
I did. I still haven't popped it in the system, but I did purchase it. And this week coming up is my spring break, so I'll have some time playing around with it.
And you bought that on the.
Xbox One.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, I was waffling on the Xbox One or the PC, but I know more people who are getting in on the Xbox One, so I figure if I want to be shot in the dark zone by anybody, it would be by a friend.
I bought it on PC because I'm an idiot.
Yeah.
Plus,
I mean
$30 is a lot easier a pill to swallow than 60.
with the beta I played, the way it's set up and the UI and all the menuing and whatnot, it bodes much better for the PC, I would think.
Yeah, so far,
You have
like
to
I played maybe a half hour.
Yeah, you got to go through Uplay and whatnot, but still,
Well, and
it's
it tells me straight up when I start the game, it's like your system doesn't meet the minimum required specs, so good
you're getting
luck.
it. You're getting a new one in the mail.
I am. Like, I should be getting it in a couple weeks at the latest. So that's kind of why I bought that Far Cry Primal on my PC because I would like to flex its muscle just a little bit. Yeah. And plus, it's still kind of playable. Kind of. I don't know.
If
I've been looking at
you
it
like
locked to a good 30 frames a second.
Yeah, if
So.
you like a picture slideshow of a game, then.
I keep it locked around 30 on PC. I scaled it way back. You know, kind of get the console experience at that point.
Yeah,
30 frames per
I
second.
haven't really flexed the new because I did a RAM upgrade and a graphics card upgrade, and I haven't really messed around with all too much. I'm just like, hey, this game plays. It wouldn't play before, so now it plays, and I'm happy.
I'll get you a copy of The Witcher 3 or
I
something
mean,
like
I bought Elite Dangerous, so I'm thinking maybe I'll play around with that and see how that is.
that. That is quite the interesting game. So, I believe we're at the point in the show where we answer questions, yeah?
Oh, the best point in the show.
Yeah, let me go ahead and pull up those questions here real quick, unless there are any other games you want to talk about.
No, I'm pretty good. I don't think anything big's coming out
I'm
now
looking
that the
forward to
Division's
spending more
out.
time with Division and.
Yeah, I want to play the Division. I want to play in April is in Quantum whatever, Quantum fucking Alan Wake
Break.
people, right? What the hell?
Yeah, it's
Quantum
Quantum
Break?
Break.
Quantum Break,
Now,
right?
are you pre-ordering it on the Xbox One
I
digitally?
did already through Amazon.
Ah, darn.
Why?
Because if you pre-purchase it or pre-order it on your Xbox One from the Xbox store, like the actual like built-in store by it digitally, you get a free copy for PC.
Oh,
Pretty crazy.
I remember reading that, and then the console people were like, "But they don't get a free copy." And but oh no, the PC people were like, "Well, we don't get a free copy on the Xbox One if we bought it on PC." There's some dumb shit. And it's like, well, they get a free copy, but we don't, and we're I don't fucking
That is
understand.
correct. You do
They
not.
should be happy that they got the game to come to PC because
Yeah.
it wasn't slated for that.
Its requirements are pretty steep,
They should be
but
thanking Phil Spencer for saying, hey, maybe we should put all of our games on the PC.
kind of thinking about grabbing it like that because I would like to have it on PC, but at the same time, I don't know if I'd ever play it. Like, I don't know. Just one copy really does feel like enough for me. So I don't know. It's kind of weird.
Yeah, I mean, that feels like a couch game to me. It does feel like a couch game.
Well, and hey, they're also putting Forza 6 Apex on the PC, and that will be free. Something like 60 cars,
So
60 cars.
does Microsoft have their own service, like downloadable service or anything like
They're,
that?
yeah, within Windows 10, which most people, I believe, were forced to upgrade
Yeah,
today,
I have
if they
Windows
had
10.
not yet.
Yeah, so
There is
the
a store icon for the Windows Store in your computer, and that's where it will be.
our networked PCs at school, all of the desktops that are in the classrooms, when I walked in today, little Windows 10 thing in the corner. I'm like, who the hell said we should download Windows 10 on this thing? It's
Oh boy.
These are Dell Optiplexes that are for classroom use. We don't need to upgrade shit. So I guess they are making that push today.
That was this morning, I believe. We had some phone calls from people at work that were like, "What happened to my computer?" It's like, "Oh, guess what? Welcome to the 21st century." And then some. So anyway, questions. We got a question from Michael Hogan. Hopefully not to be confused with Hulk Hogan, who's currently in the Gawker trial and it's going to clean up because Gawker is scum. Like Hulk Hogan's scum too, but even scum have a right to privacy. But that's just me. They basically were the ones who leaked the sex tape.
Yeah.
Zero.
They should have just released the racist shit and none of the sex part. It would have been fine, right?
It would have been better. A little bit better.
Much
Anywho,
better.
Michael Hogan, brother, says, about to finish up with Persona 1 Golden on my PS Vita, and I need a new RPG to play. Which PS1 classic RPG should I
Oh,
play?
first of all, avoid buying any PS1 classics simply because the load times are going to kill you.
Just
Like
like a rogue
you will walk away from all of those. PS1 classics, no, you
The
would.
original Grandia. I will wait
Yeah,
there.
the Grandias, yeah, the original Grandia.
Best
They
battle
have
system in
Suikoden, Suikoden 2, right? Suikoden
RPG.
2,
Yeah,
right?
those are both there, first and second.
Yeah. Final Fantasy Tactics is always a good one. I'm always a big fan of that one.
Yeah, that's had some remakes over the years, but I
That did,
believe
yeah.
it's
You'd
still
rather
the
pick that up on the GBA or the DS because there's no load times on that one. So I think on the DS it's Final Fantasy Tactics Line Wars, I think it is, because they had a couple other ones that are called Final Fantasy
Yeah, and then there
Tactics
was
on the
like
Genesis system.
A2
Yeah,
and
Advanced One, Advanced
just
Two, yeah.
some strange stuff going on.
Yeah.
So those are our answers. There are good
Yeah.
classic PS1 RPGs that are compatible with the Vita because not necessarily every game is on their
Like
stores.
Chrono Cross is on there, Chrono
Yeah.
Trigger's on there. Most of the.
Yeah, I've got Chrono Cross, but I never played it. I need to do
It's different. It is different, man. It's
that. Okay.
it has a Suikoden feel because it has a lot of characters, a lot of characters. So, I mean, it's the load times that'll get you like every single time. Like I have it on the, I bought it off of the PlayStation store. I have it on the Vita, and it's just like every time I try and play it, it just. It's I'm so we're so pampered now without those fucking
Yeah.
optical disc load times, those
Those are bad.
PlayStation 1 CD-ROM load drives, right? So
However, we were just complaining about Street Fighter V's load times.
those are wait times, those are different, right? We're not loading for shit. Now
That's
the UFC load times where it slows down the music, I guess we could complain
a
about
little
those,
different.
right?
They're not
Yeah.
extended, but there's
Yeah.
a pay, there's a
Yeah.
exchange there. All right, our next question is from Ben Villamek, and actually this works out perfect for both of us. Did you find the choice at the end of Firewatch was more informed by the events of the game or by your own personality?
I haven't finished Firewatch, so I'm not sure.
The
I'm just gonna say it's what do you know what choice he's talking about?
I'm trying to remember.
Yeah. Well, if you can't remember, then it was blatantly based off of the events in the game, right? Because you
I
would remember.
remember very clearly what happened, but I don't remember choosing anything.
Yeah. Maybe you're such a shitty person during the game, they didn't give you the other option.
It could also be a weird tweet that wasn't written properly and he's actually asking something else.
Yeah.
I'm just like stumbling over to
It
what.
may maybe it has like the ending of Oxenfree where I get the good ending and you have no idea what I was talking about the whole
No
time.
ending whatsoever.
Yeah.
God, so frustrating. Oh, I wish I had that so bad.
Oh, it was so good. It was so good. Sorry,
Jake
it'd only
Field.
be game of the year to 5% of the people who played it.
That would have changed how I felt about a lot of it.
Yeah.
Jake Zielsdorf asks, what changes do you want to see to Pokemon Sun and Moon? Man, I don't know. It doesn't sound like they need to
To
make
be
any changes.
honest, I've been tempted to buy a fucking new 3DS because
Hey, Super
they just
Nintendo games.
released they just released not the new 3DS XL, but the new 3DS. It's got the Famicom buttons, it's got interchangeable face plates, so I could get my fucking swag on right there.
Yep,
And
too bad.
I mean, there's a lot of good games for the 3DS that I think would be nice to play. So I might get on the Pokemon train when it happens. The problem is I haven't played a Pokemon train since Pokemon game since like Red and Blue,
That's all right. It's a good
right?
time to jump in.
So it's like any new system they put it, everything's new to me, man. I don't know anything about breeding. I don't know anything about these new looking Pokemons or whatnot, right? I
Don't
watched the
worry, they have these terrible long tutorials in there
I
anyways.
watched the I watched the speed run of somebody speed running Pokemon Blue, catching every single Pokemon, lots of glitches and whatnot.
Right.
And there's even some Pokemons in there where it's like, oh shit, that's right, Krabby was a Pokemon. And who's this garbage looking motherfucker? I guess that was one of the 151, because
I liked Burmy. It looked like
151 of
trash.
them, 151 of them, that's a lot to remember. And now there's what, like 2 million of them? I mean, come on.
Yep. We got another question here. This one is from Seth Chenard. Real simple. You looking forward to Doom? Yes. Yes, I am. The original Doom is one of the greatest games of all time.
You
Still
were
very.
a big fan of it, yes.
Still am. Like, it holds up so good. It's perfect almost.
I don't
God.
think it holds up that well, but
Man, it's so good.
I mean, as keyboard only games go, I guess it holds up all right, you
Yeah.
know?
Well, yeah, what there were no jump buttons.
Yeah, there's
There's
no jump,
right button that you had to kind of
there's
look at
no
stuff to
look up
adjust.
or down. It just auto-aimed. If I lined them up, it would automatically aim up, right?
Yes.
Yes, so
It had auto elevation aim,
yeah.
which actually I had no problems with
No,
whatsoever.
not at all at the time. I mean, now it's like, oh, I can't aim up, but before it's just like, I'll just spray in a circle and people are gonna get shot.
Yeah.
I don't know, when I first saw the trailer for it at this past E3, I was like, this game looks pretty fun, but I'm not excited for it. I guess I don't really get excited for games all that often anymore. I don't know,
Doom,
but
man. Then again, Doom 3 was a real
Closet
non-event.
Monsters, your Closet
It
Monster
just
game.
wasn't that great. Like,
Yeah,
I had trouble.
I mean, this looks like it's fast-paced original Doom, some Quake feel to it as well, because it's fast-paced, but
Yeah.
should be all right.
I am excited. I love Doom. And I will play every Doom from here on out until forever. And hey, there was that John Romero put out that redone, not really redone, but he created his own Episode 1 Map 8 because that was the only map in the original series of Doom that he did not create. Somebody else did that. So he made his own recently. Like, that's so cool that he did that for the original. Ah,
Yeah.
that's so cool.
Well, maybe they're gonna tie in you buy the Doom on Xbox One, you get the Xbox Live Arcade edition of Doom that has the new updated map, right? They can do
I'll
that.
play
They
that
can
for a
do that,
dollar.
man. They have the power now to give you whatever back cap games you want, right?
Yeah, very cool. All right, for our last question here, this is from Jared. Streets of Rage 2 is coming to vinyl. I guess the soundtrack. What game soundtrack would get you to buy a record player? None of them. I don't want a record player. I do not care about vinyl. I never have. The best part of vinyl was that you got big ass album art that you
Yeah.
could study.
Yeah.
That one.
Looks nice.
But that's it. I never cared for the sound. Not a big deal to me.
Yeah, I mean, high five. It's you're paying for the sound, it's you're paying for the charm of the needle grinding against this piece of plastic for the most part.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know if I would buy anything. I mean, I think it was cool for the Life is Strange limited edition where they were giving away some of the soundtracks on vinyl. I thought that was kind of cool,
That is cool.
you know, because a
But
little
the thing is,
collector's thing, but
what's weird to me about it, because like regular music being on vinyl, that's normal. But there's this, it's like putting out
yeah, it's like putting
game
out.
music on an 8-track. It's like it never belonged here ever.
Yeah, it's like these chippy tune types of things and putting it on, but yeah,
Yeah,
this
so.
over digitized sound that goes on here, right?
Yep. So that's how I feel about it.
But what
So,
Streets
what
of
would
Rage was was Sega, right? Genesis.
Yes, it
They
was.
had better. They had a better sound card than the SNES. So.
Ooh, it depends. Streets of Rage had one of the greatest sound
Well, I mean
components.
the actual
Like, I
console. Like, I'm not saying like the people who developed for the Sega had better ability to write a score. The actual Sega had a better processor for sound, just for actual music. They might not have taken advantage of it for every single game, but
Are you trying to say that Sega does what Nintendo don't?
no, because Nintendo has got that Mode 7, right?
Oh, we
Woo-wee!
do that.
So much better than those blast physics.
Saw that in Contra 3, the Alien Wars, or F-Zero. You go,
Super
oh, this thing.
Castlevania man in the barrel level.
Oh,
Oh
everything
man.
turned. Everything turned and rotated, and
Yeah.
shit was lost. I think that's our show for this week. What do you think?
I think we're good.
All right. I'd like to thank everybody who did tune in. Hope you enjoyed the show. You can follow either one of us too. At Dr. Gumar, DrGumAer on Twitter. And I'm Sunflower 4000, because I'm 4000 years in the future. Whatever. You can also follow Games Only Cast, where we will publish when we're going live, things like that. We don't spam it with news or anything like that. But if we see a crazy deal, someone will retweet it.
Mostly that's
Something
HP.
about HP.
HP does, yeah.
Feel free to follow us. Feel free to send us any questions at Games Only Cast. And we will see y'all next week. Thank you for listening.
Bye.
Have a good night.
Boop, boop.